What's up, everybody? It's your girl Brittany coming back at you with another video. Before we get into this, I'm gonna need y'all to hit that like button and subscribe with post notifications on so you can keep up with all the latest trending news and gossip going on in these social media streets. So K Michelle was recently trending the internet for the smell of her vagina. This isn't the first time K Michelle Sugar Bowl has been the topic of conversation. All this coochie talk started 6 years ago when Soulja Boy insinuated that he smashed K Michelle during an interview with some of his castmates from Love and Hip Hop Hollywood.
I smashed K Michelle.
Did you smash K Michelle?
K Michelle didn't appreciate Soulja Boy lying on her cooch, so she called him out in an interview she had on The Breakfast Club.
Soulja Boy implies that he slept with me.
Really?
Yes. And she says, he was like, he's giggling. He's like, no, I didn't say that. And then he's giggling. You can giggle on these nuts. Let me tell you something, Soulja Boy, because I know you're going to hear this. What you're not going to do is lie on my hot pocket.
There you go.
I take, when I do something, I say I did it. Mm-hmm. And that's what it is. So that giggling, we don't want to giggle about the transgender in Atlanta. Giggle, giggle. Now crank
that. Oh, gosh.
Crank that.
There it is.
We don't want to giggle
about
that.
But I thought you said he said no, he didn't.
He said he's giggling like he did. You know, he was implying. When you watch the video.
I got to see it.
Yeah, he was trying to, like, make people think.
Maybe he was just high.
I don't care what he was.
Okay.
You don't play when it comes to me in my high pocket. I've never seen you or met you a day in my life.
That might have been the same week he put the fake money out on Instagram, so probably. He was faking everything.
He's faking everything.
K Michelle's statements about Soulja Boy being with trans sparked a Twitter beef between them that led to Soulja Boy saying this. Ever since then, the smell of K Michelle's box has been something to joke about in the hip hop community.
Well, you got stank with Maino, this is what you use.
I have a gift for you. No, look, I went and got burgers and fries for Kay. I ate the fries because they were hot, and I knew this one was going to be here by the time they, you know. So I ate the fries, still got the burger, got everything on the side. But this is the most special gift I got for you.
What is
so
it?
I have a home girl. No, I have a home girl. She says sell something called panty cake.
Okay, what is this going to do?
Listen, okay, I want you to smell it first. Smell it. Now, you know how you be busy all day, right?
Okay.
Here's what you do. When you get out of the shower, you put some on your fingers. And you put, and
you?
Not in you, but on, you know, all up in the crevices. And you know what I'm saying? So you can go all day, right? You can have tight yeast infection jeans on. You can go to the gym and not shower. And when you get home, it's going to smell like that after all day.
I heard a few stories about K Michelle. The stories that I heard about K Michelle was that her box thing.
Every year since 2014, Uncle Myrtle puts out a song summing up things that took place in hip-hop that year. In 2014, Uncle Myrtle put out the 2014 wrap-up, and in that song, he stated five dudes told him K Michelle's coochie stank.
I say shit that make niggas think. Five niggas told me K Michelle pussy stink.
Him and K Michelle had a little beef about that, and then life went on. Fast forward 2 years later, Maino and Uncle Murda had an interview on The Breakfast Club, and Angela Yee decided it would be a good idea to bring up the smell of K Michelle's coochie again.
You did say something about K Michelle.
Oh, whoa! She got that stink. Y'all call it the K Michelle.
Why would you say that?
I know people that did certain things with her.
Oh. Maino, let me smell your finger.
I'm just saying. I ain't gonna say who, but it's a putting out a mixtape with you.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna pass out.
Did you have sex with K Michelle?
What? What is that? What kind of question is that?
Right.
Like, well, I'm no.
Maino.
Yo, if Joe Burns just text me, he'll still eat it.
I mean, how they say the box was though? They just said it smelled. How was it though?
Why you asking
her?
Yeah, don't ask me. I don't know.
No, I'm saying, what your man say?
Oh, my man said it was not right.
Of course, that sparked up issues again. So when K Michelle went on to The Breakfast Club the following week, she confronted Angela Yee for being messy and bringing up the smell of her box.
Now, we had Maino and Uncle Murder up here too, Kay. Mm-hmm. And they were saying your vagina stink.
You don't even know me, Uncle Murder. I didn't even know who, honestly, I didn't know who he was. Mm-hmm. Until they said, it was like, it was a song. And I was like, oh, okay, it's Soulja Boy stuff or whatever. And they always say a woman is a bitch, she's a hoe, this, that. So I really didn't take it in because it didn't affect my pay. So then when I found out who he was, and I was like, he gets so like excited and geared, you know, like riled up. Mm-hmm. When you ask him that, he like, I saw the interview, I was like, he's really like happy. He's never met me. I do know Maino. And I was kind of like, Maino, you're sitting there in that, okay.
So you called
Maino
about
get
it?
On, mm-mm.
Okay,
no,
okay.
No. I didn't. I said I was gonna just kind of just let it go because at the end of the day, it really doesn't affect anything about me.
You know what, though? I thought about it after, and I was thinking, I know you and Little Kim had some issues.
It's all of this little crew. You
know
what
I'm saying?
And I was
thinking that Maino be with, you know.
Even with you, you're a woman. And I think I've been very cool and very supportive of you. The interview was over and the credits were running. You brought that back up. And the thing about that is, I know you want ratings, but you are a woman. And no woman wants a body, and no woman wants nothing like that on them. So they wasn't even talking about that. You brought that back up.
No,
you've already interviewed
him. And I mentioned what had happened.
It didn't get brought back up. I seen it. You knew. You're close with Atlantic. Mm-hmm. You knew my album came out the next day. You didn't know what legs that boot was going to take. You get what I'm saying? But thank God people know me, and people actually was looking at those like, oh, them some cornballs. You ain't gonna be Oprah like that. You're gonna be somebody else. Ricky Lake come and gone. Because it's a time and a place. Because two women, you don't know at what point the first shall be last and the last shall be first. And you don't know that. So thank God my label was concerned on a Thursday that, oh my God, Kay's going to get on Twitter, she's going to act out, but I got different kind of checks and I can't do that. But I got PR at the label like, oh, here we go, more beef, more drama, and we really want to focus on this music.
But you didn't call it this time, though.
No, I just didn't say nothing. But you brought that up. Not him. And at the end of the day, I ain't with you for that. So let's move on.
Just a few days ago, Maino was on his podcast, Kitchen Talk, interviewing actor Jason Mitchell. During that interview, Maino brought up Kay Michelle and proceeded to talk about how bad her coochie smells.
Popular female.
Okay.
Maybe an R&B singer.
Okay.
I went to the hotel with this lady.
Okay.
And this is my first time, and I said, damn, I want to do this.
Right.
I've been watching her. Watching her, I want to do this. She want to do me.
Okay,
we get in there. Things is happening. Matter of fact, she goes into the shower. We had the Trump over there. When it was the Trump solo.
The Trump solo, yeah.
It used to be the Trump solo.
Right, it's not a Trump supporter.
That's the greenhouse.
I know
personally.
It's cool.
Not right, but she came out the shower. I was like, yeah, it's about to happen.
Right.
And we started to get into something. And then I was just like, damn, what's that smell?
You said it out loud?
No, I'm saying it in my mind.
Okay.
And I'm saying to myself, like, you don't smell this? She never said nothing. I never said nothing. But it was so crazy that it was playing tricks on my mind.
Right.
I said, she don't smell this shit? This is crazy. I'm in here losing my mind. I'm saying, well, maybe it's me.
Who was it?
Was it?
I can't stop thinking of it.
And he called me.
Because now I'm like, you got
called me like, yo.
You know who it was, too?
He called me like, yo, that shit,
messy.
Yo.
Y'all know who it is.
That shit's sanitation.
Why y'all don't?
Sanitation.
And I'm like, nah, bro. I'm not going for that.
When are y'all?
You could have been off there.
But here's the
Here's the Brooklyn shit.
Go
back in. Make sure you ain't bugging.
Yeah, I had to go back in. Just to make sure.
Why didn't you say something to her?
See, you still sticking with it. Still sticking with it.
No, it's not her. Why wouldn't you tell a woman that? It's not even about her. It's about the situation. Why wouldn't you tell a woman that? I'm gonna tell you if your boss.
Her nose is working like his nose is working.
Let me say this then, since you asked me the question. I was offended. I called him every step of the way. I didn't really have a heart to say nothing. I said, why the fuck is she on national TV with her shit smelling like that? What? I'm this is me. Why you hurting me like that?
You're hurting me. Yo, he always
me, say,
a
yo,
victim.
He called me and said, yo, the sheep fanned it up. The sheep fanned up. And that shit just hit me. I said, damn, bro, not her.
After that clip went viral, the Shade Room posted a few tweets that K. Michelle made. And guess who had something to say? Memphitz. I thought that was interesting since K. Michelle has been very vocal in the past about Memphitz abusing her.
He admitted what happened? He admitted that he abused you?
He admitted it to the label.
Who did he admit it to?
To the, like, the Peter Edges and people at the label, to his own person, Glenn Delgado, that was working under him. And I got out of my record label. I owe $2 million. Labels don't let you go with that over your head. You're still going to have a tag on you when you go to the next label. I own everything. I got my publishing back and everything because I went through that. I had text messages of everything, all the abuse, everything, and I would forward them over. And it, what could they say other than, we got to let her go. She's going to sue. We got to get her out of here. So...
Did you ever think about taking legal action against the label or against him for what happened? And why didn't you go to the police when this happened?
It was my fault. Like, I should have went to the police when it happened. I was in love. That was my best friend. And he has his own issues from the killing of his father and different things that he went through. I wasn't trying to take him down. You know what I'm saying? I was in love. You go through self-esteem issues. Maybe I was wrong. You know, I didn't want to leave him. So after that happened, I did leave. So, you know, it was a lot. And the label, I never thought about, hey, I'm going to sue them, you know, because you don't want to get blackballed in the music industry. And I wasn't saying I might sue until they wouldn't let me go. I wanted to go. It's like you can have everything. You can have these songs I wrote. Just get me free. I want to be free. So... You know, finally when that happened, I got a great lawyer, and through everything, you know, for them to actually read the kind of things that were being said and done to me, I was able to be let go.
Which led to a beef between K. Michelle and Rashida on Love & Hip Hop Atlanta.
I just thank you for not taking sides in the situation.
But if he says he's sorry, then where does that put you? Does that take you to another place?
You know what it does? It at least makes me feel like there is some good.
Maybe he's not doing that because that's not something that he did to you.
Rashida, he did that to me. I had scars all on my leg, carpet burns from fighting. 3 years, my career was ruined because I could not talk. I don't have that no more. I don't care what nobody got to say about me, because that's my... None of y'all was there. None of y'all. That man beat my ass, and I had to deal with that. So I don't give a f- what nobody think about nothing I got going on.
Wow. Let's start with you, Rashida. You'd heard K. Michelle tell you the story so many times, and there were points where you empathized with her and understood her story. What was different that time? What made you take a different position?
To be honest with you, I've been friends with them for a very long, long time, okay. And I'm very, very close to his wife, you know? And I heard both sides of the story.
What are your thoughts now on the subject, on everything that you've heard from K. Michelle?
You know what? To be honest with you, it ain't got nothing to do with me, but at the end of the day, I don't know if I believe K. Michelle.
Okay.
Oh, wow. Thank you. Regardless of anything, for 3 years, I've been helping women who went through domestic violence. So regardless of how crazy K. Michelle is or how I act, I don't say I act right. I don't always act right. I never have said I was this picture-perfect woman. What I said was, what happened to me is what happened to me. And Rashida, you don't have to believe it, but you show sat there every episode getting your check.
Damn
listening
straight.
To did what it was. You show cried at everything with me in my hand. But when the first episode came out and it got tough, you got to run it.
Oh, I ain't run.
Yes, you did. Tough.
No, I didn't.
When it got tough, the boss left.
I had to put two and two together and say, huh, something don't make no damn sense.
What don't make? How I get out a $2 million record deal on everything? They didn't let me go.
Listen.
Like they let you go on yours. My
and you're not
story,
gonna get them.
It's my story.
Yeah, and that's
The beef between K. Michelle and Memphitz ex-wife Toya Johnson, who is also the ex-wife of Lil Wayne and the mother of his oldest child, Regine.
The person, the picture she's painting of my husband is not my husband. I've been knowing him for 6 years. I knew several women that he have dated that never said anything about abuse. And I mean, if somebody abused you like that, where's the proof? Where's the police report? Where's the pictures? Where's the messages that you claim that he sent threats to your kid and threatening to kill your child? These are things that it don't matter about love. You would be in jail if you threatened my kid. And I was not there when y'all had the altercation, true. But I'm gonna be 100% supportive of my man. I don't know you. I don't know the person that you this abuser. I never met that guy.
Memphitz denied the abuse allegations, but it said that he eventually admitted to the abuse in court documents. Not sure how true it is that he admitted to that because I haven't seen those documents. However, I do believe that he put his hands on K. Michelle, and based off this next clip, I wouldn't be surprised if he did the same to Toya.
Stay in your lane.
What does that mean?
That means stay in your lane and stay out of my business.
What type of answers I get? Break it down. What does stay in your lane mean?
Okay, so stop talking. You got to talking me too. I don't stop doing nothing. I do what the I want to do.
Calm down.
And I ain't calming down.
Like you got to.
You don't tell me I'm going to be okay.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Out of here. This house.
Memphitz is supposed to be a different person now, with newly found inner peace, and is even in a new relationship. So I don't know why he felt the need to comment, because if it was me and I was truly happy, I would have kept scrolling. But y'all, let me know what y'all think about K. Michelle and her box down in the comment section below. If you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will talk to you in my next video.